Hi, my name is Carter Hendrickson, and these are my colleagues, Jason Eiler, Cooper Wills, and Samuel Corum. And we're pitching the idea of having four-day school weeks because we want to encourage a change in the school system to possibly enhance the efficiency of the school and its students. After surveying around 150 students and faculty, we found that 98.5% of them were in favor of four-day weeks.
So, like Carter said, our proposal is to change the traditional five-day school week to a four-day school week, in that we would go Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then the extra day would be on Friday.
Basically, this would benefit the school faculty and staff, the students, and the students' parents. And like Carter said, we surveyed those people, and that was a student-teacher-based survey, so they thought it would work out as well.
Some of the benefits are financial gain. It improves learning, more free time, and improves attendance. Also, it promotes responsibility. Thank you. We are now open for questions.
Do you know of any schools that do this?
Well, there's 20 across the country, or I think it's 21, and then there's 120 school districts that do it. So.
And what are the, like, I'm curious to see what the parents would think. Did you all survey any parents?
We did not.
Okay. And I'm just thinking from the perspective of, because I have high school, but then I also have little ones. So, like, what do you do with the little ones?
We said that was, this would just be
only
high school.
Okay. Just because, like, transportation and stuff, like, it'd be unbeneficial for younger kids, probably.
You said that it increased learning. Yeah. Can you back up why they said it improved learning?
I read an article that said that when they surveyed the students, they actually got the opposite of what they thought would happen. They thought that longer school days and longer hours in the classroom would make students like more fatigued and stuff like that. But actually the mathematics part of it, when like the statistics, they skyrocketed, like that part. The students were learning more in math, but other subjects like science and stuff, they went up too. But then English, that's the only subject that kind of just stayed the same.
So when they do the 4-day week, they increase the number of hours in the day.
Yeah, yes.
Probably 9 to 5.
So what would our schedule look like? Did you all think about that?
Like the hour schedule? We thought about sports-wise, like many public schools around here, there, since we would add an hour, and if you're taking like all the electives, you can't take another one, you would just have a sports elective. That's what many public schools around here do. So like Carter right now, he would have a basketball, like his last period would be basketball, so like he wouldn't have to stay up till 12 o'clock at night doing homework just because he got out at 5 that day.
I could just spend the last hour of the day going to practice silver time, practicing until 9 o'clock.
And even for sports like golf, like we used to have those three nets down in the basement right behind the gym, so for like the last hour we can just go hit out there. But usually for like golf, we practice as a team. But for our team practice, that would be it. But usually when we practice in like hardcore, we usually just start out of course, and it's not during school hours anyways.
Also like academic team or any other extracurriculars, you'd have that last. So like a high percentage, like I'd say about 90% have something. They do, but with that, like last 10%, not sure what we would do, but it could like be a study hall or something to get your homework done.
So we're still thinking like a 7-class day, and then that 8 would just be
add on just to make up for the missed day.
Okay. Yeah. And you're thinking 9 to 5, not 8 to 4? Is there a reason for the later start date?
I just saw something that was what some schools were doing, but I would say also it helped kids like have another hour of sleep, so then they were like not fatigued or anything for class since we're staying in longer.
Essentially, you're really not changing much for the academic day per se, other than the practice or the extracurricular activity that a student does, they'll get credit for it. getting high school credit for.
This Friday, though, it's also meant to be, like, so, like, if you have, like, the way I took it is, like, it's for students that don't really know what they want to do when they're going to college, so you can do internships. So it's just a way to find, like, what you're, like, what you like and what you don't like as well. So you can find it. We could have, like, our college counselors also help us out trying to find different internships around Lexington. And we have, I mean, jobs. We already have the work release, but that would be another day, just, like.
So those schools you looked at, they have those things in place to where they're helping kids find those internships or those shadow experiences on Fridays.
It's not just a free day off.
Yeah, no, we wouldn't be like in class, but we'd still be around school utilizing.
Would that be required of all high school students then, that you're doing something like that on a Friday?
There would have to be some accountability. It couldn't just be like, well, I'm not old enough to have jobs, so I'm not going to do anything. I mean, there's something you can do to get out there.
Did it show where those internships and shadow opportunities, were they tied to a class, like a regular one of those 7 class periods, or were they?
They were just separate from the class period.
Kind of like an extra elective, yeah. And that's, you know, your Friday schedule.
Basically.
So the teachers you talk to, because essentially we're dropping Friday, but Monday through Thursday stays the same, so they're not even getting an extra half hour in there. So they're now taking what they teach in 5 hours during the week, and they're teaching in 4. Did anyone seem concerned about that?
The only two that it was not in favor was MERS and Siemens. MERS, I'm guessing, just because he likes to spend more time with us. And then Siemens was the paycheck. Mm-hmm. He's like, it'll take money out of my paycheck. But, yeah, Small was in favor for it, which I was surprised.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you think about Coach Mers or any teacher that's preparing for AP test. I mean, you're trying to squeeze 4 5 days into 4. That's putting a lot of pressure on the teacher, and it's putting a lot of pressure on the students to feel like, I've got to get this under this grasp in 4 days.
If you went to a 4-day school week, would you change your attendance policy at all? Would students be allowed to miss less days because they're already technically missing a day a week?
I mean, if it came to that, I think so. But, like, it said it would improve attendance just because, like, parents or kids wouldn't be, like, scheduling appointments on those days. They'd take more advantage of the days we have for school and just schedule it like a Friday. So, like, the internship thing, I doubt it would last all 8 hours of school, so then it'd almost be like a half day, pretty much. So then, like, for the other half of the day, either you get a head start on, like, studying for tests or doing homework or scheduling those appointments on those days.
Definitely think you can get away with the attendance because they're all doing that on the Fridays, so it's not much to ask for another.
Are any of the school districts or anywhere in Kentucky doing this?
I don't think so in Kentucky.
I think the one I read about.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there is a, what's the, there's,
well,
a Latin,
there's the Latin
school.
They
that's,
do.
That's like 3 days.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's.
Yeah. Go
on. I would love to see that explored. My biggest concern is 9th and 10th graders. Like, I think for juniors and seniors, they could flourish in that type of situation, but I would really have concern over the 9th and 10th graders. One, where their placement's going to be, how they're going to get there, and you said promotes responsibility. And without direct supervision over a bunch of 9th and 10th graders, I don't see how it's going to promote their responsibility. I think it's going to be.
Both of it would work. We could do just juniors and seniors, but that'd be difficult, I think.
Also, I mean, if we did do that, we could also have juniors and seniors that, like, wanted to go into teaching, and, like, they could supervise, they could be a teacher at it.
Yeah.
To the 9th grade.
Guys, did you share with them why you picked this particular idea? I was out for a second. I'm just curious if you shared with them. What made you go with this idea over something else?
reason I said it was because the exploring, I don't know what I'm undecided for college. So, I mean, it's just a way to get out there and figure out what I want to do. I don't know. I like law. That's pretty much it.
And it appeals to you, Carter, because of the basketball and
number of
hours.
That. And then plus, like, the Friday, because I want to go into business type stuff so I can go intern and do stuff like that.
I want to go into business just like Carter, but like there's a wide range of things, so I'm not positive of what field of business I want to go to, but it would help for the Friday thing. So.
Good job, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.